Hey, welcome back to Case Study Tuesday, folks. This is Marcel. I'm standing in the common area, the hallway of an apartment building. This is a deal I picked up using a direct mail piece. Don't forget to tune in to Direct Mail Wednesdays tomorrow. So I'm gonna show you unit number one. I'm walking into the living room of this unit. This is a one bedroom unit, okay? The bedroom is over here to the left. This property has high ceilings in the bedrooms. There's window units for AC. We're gonna take out the window units in this entire building, and we're gonna put new cooling and heating systems in. Now, we're also gonna take out the ceiling fans. We're gonna do new baseboards, new trim, new paint. It's gonna be a really nice looking apartment. Okay, walking through the living room is gonna lead us to the dining room. Now, the tenant in this unit actually has access to the storage down in the basement, the storage area. I'm standing in the dining room. I'm standing in the dining room right now. And the dining room has a closet. This is really a funky looking floor plan. We're gonna open this up. We're gonna make this more of a formal dining room. This is right off of the kitchen. And we're gonna take this old carpet up out of here. It stinks, number one. It's got a bunch of stains. I highly recommend that you do not put carpet in your rental properties. Do not do that. And when we go into the rehab segment, I'll show you exactly the type of flooring you should be putting into your rental properties. We're also going to walk into the kitchen area. Now, the kitchen area, you know, this is where your tenants are going to spend a lot of their time. So we're going to make this really nice. Now, the cool thing about this particular unit is that we don't have to replace the cabinets. So anywhere throughout your projects where you can save money, I highly recommend. We're gonna clean these up with some Ajax or some Comet really good, clean them up, and we don't even have to put hardware on. The only thing we're gonna do in the kitchen is the flooring. We're gonna paint, we're gonna get rid of these old appliances, probably sell them, get some money out of them. You know, even if you get $50 to $100 from an old appliance, that's money you don't have to spend on the next appliances. Off of the kitchen is a bathroom. One thing that I did not mention is that we're gonna take out all the interior doors, give this unit some pop, some new fresh exterior doors. We're gonna add a security door in the back of the house because it's an old screen door. In this particular neighborhood, you do have break-ins. So we're gonna make sure that this unit is secure. But there's a website that I wanna share with you. I didn't share this earlier. This unit's gonna rent for $1,000 a month. Okay, $1,000 a month. We're going through a program that focuses on helping older men get back on their feet. Now, I recommend that you use one of the best websites in the world, Google, and find out the different subsidized programs in your marketplace that would possibly lease from you if you're going into this business as a landlord. There's a website that I want to share with you. You may know already about it. It's been around for years. It's called rentometer.com, R-E-N-T-O-meter.com, where you can figure out how much your houses, how much your apartments are going to rent for in your marketplace. Folks, I'm signing out. I look forward to seeing you at the closing table. Take care.